What's up, guys? Welcome to Daily Dose of Reddit. This is your host, Zach, and today's subreddit is r/entitledpeople. Alright, this story's called Entitled Sister Says I'm Wasting Our Mom's Money, Even Though It's Mine. So a little backstory, this might be a long one. My older sister, the entitled person, 28, has always said something against me, 17, female. She always says that I'm the favorite child and that I'm a spoiled brat. She thinks I'm the favorite because mom and I are always doing stuff together, like watching movies and TV shows and going out to big shopping centers together, and saying I'm a brat because I have all these new clothes, I'm a cosplayer, and how that's wasting all of mom's money. One, mom and I are always doing stuff together because we have common interests, and she's made the effort to watch some anime with me because I think she might enjoy a certain show. Two, I have, in total, maybe 20 different cosplay items. In total, counting wigs and uniforms and all that. And out of all of it, my mom only bought me 3 or 4 things, even after I insisted that I pay. Three, the money I get is all from saving up cans. Yeah, those 10 cents go all towards my hobby that I'm very passionate about. And mom totally supports me because she sees how happy it makes me and will be there if I need any of her help. But when my sister was my age, she would be distant from the family and treat mom with such disrespect. Even now, she continues to boss mom around and even started stealing from me. A couple of months ago, she stole around 7 bags of cans, which would have been 50 to 60 bucks, which isn't much to some people, but for me, that was a huge dent in my allowance of getting my cosplays. She's also loudly announced to the whole family that I commit self-harm a few months ago, during our little family get together for our brother's birthday. Mom has tried to talk to her about it, but she keeps seeing her actions as okay. She's done worse throughout my life, but this post is already long enough. After all she's done, I've just started distancing myself from her. What should I even do about her? Edit. First, thank you to everyone that gave me some advice. I really appreciate it. I have been trying to avoid my sister, and it's kinda easy to since she's moved out. The thing is, she's always like this, even though she has 2 kids and a wedding to worry about instead of her little sister. Reminder, my sister and her fiancé both have stable jobs and don't have any money struggles. Meanwhile, I'm still unemployed with no income at all. I know that there's the chance that she might have needed a couple of extra bucks, but seriously, stealing from your little sister? How I get my cans is saving up from home and sometimes walking all around my town with big bin bags to pick up all the stray cans, beer bottles, etc. And I have tried talking to my mom about it, and she's still a pushover for my sister. A few years back, my sister was the queen bee of the house and always bossing poor mom around, saying that she had to do this and can't do that. Mom's still kind of like that, but I told her that she doesn't have to keep asking me if she can do stuff, but she forgets. Recently, my sister found my TikTok account and started yelling at me how I'm a spoiled brat and how I have it easy, even though she knows my bad past, and that I hate getting stuff in general because I've grown the mentality that I don't deserve it, all because of her. This caused me to have a panic attack and delete all my videos, which I highly regret now, but I've started cosplaying and uploading again. I saw that someone said I should do something with her so we can have even ground. Thanks, but that won't work. My sister judges every little thing about me. I can't like or do the smallest things without having her say something about it. E.g., when my sister was younger, she was into Sailor Moon but grew out of it. Then I found the old anime and it's my favorite and my comfort show. She says that liking it and anime in general is stupid and childish, even though her fiancé is into anime. And she's walked in on me watching Attack on Titan when people are getting killed and eaten. I want to have a good relationship with my sisters since I've been separated from my family for a long time, and I just want to be like a normal family. But even if my sister is like this, I still have pretty great relationships with my mom and older brother, both who I'd call my best friends. That's really sweet. Nice of you to see the silver lining like that and realize that, yeah, some family sucks, but hey, you can't discount those that don't, even if they do a little bit. But that's okay, because y'all love each other, right? Alright, this story's called Entitled Brother Tried to Trick Me into Letting Him Live With Me. Just a heads up, this is a teal deer post. This happened around Christmas. My grandmother had died the previous year and my brother had been living with her. However, after being told before my grandmother died that the house would be sold, he refused to move out, saying, "I'm working on it." Not sure what he was working on, but it didn't look like anything whenever we came by to give him food. He has a job, yet never seemed to buy food. He always calls me up demanding some of mine or demands it for my mother. Well, Christmas, I was terribly ill. I'd called out of work and wrote on Facebook that I didn't want to be bothered. The doctor said it was just a cold, but it was horrible. Whenever I breathed, I wheezed and rattled. I felt like I was in no fit state to do anything. However, my ever-loving family didn't accept sickness as a reason to skip Christmas. So my brother came and complained as he dragged me out to take me to our mother's. In the car, he smoked and said I was faking my sickness as I kept having coughing fits. He went on and on about how mom was selling the house right from underneath him, how the house belonged to him, how mom gave away grandma's car to our sister when it was his, and so forth. I was trying to stay awake, but I wasn't well, and him telling me all the things that belonged to him that weren't his was boring me. We got to mom's, and it was a nice time. Well, I think it was. I fell asleep and was woken up for dinner. My brother was mad that he got yelled at for smoking near a sick person. Dinner was the eye-opener.
"It is so nice that you're allowing your brother to live with you. I had no idea you were so close," said my mother.
"What? No, I started.
"Have some water, you sound terrible," said my brother, forcing water onto me.
"I was worried he had no place to stay, but you're helping him,"
my mom went on.
"Yes, she is, like a good big sister. She invited me to come take care of her, you know, because she is special and all," said my brother.
"No! I did it! He's not..."
I tried to say, but ended up in a coughing fit.
"She didn't invite you to stay?" asked my mom.
"She did!"
cried my brother before he leaned over and whispered to me,
"Don't be a wuss bag, you..."
I don't even want to write the slur he said here.
"I'm not able to have anyone else on my lease or to live with me,"
I choked out after my fit.
"We'll lie,"
said my brother cheerfully. I glared at him. "How will I lie? I am special, and special people can't lie," I snapped as best as I could at him. Well, that ended dinner. Before my brother was supposed to take me home, my mom offered, but my brother insisted he would. I had learned from my sisters, other brother, father, and mother that my brother had been going around telling everyone that he was moving in with me. He had told them that I was going to get a bigger place and he wouldn't even have to pay rent. I couldn't believe it. He drove me home. I was mad, but he was going on about how homeless he was when we were going back. So stupidly, after he brought in the gifts from others to me, I allowed him to stay the night. I figured, it's Christmas. It is a nice thing to do after all. This was a terrible idea. He smoked, so my place smelt like a smoker's place. He blasted the TV even after I told him not to.
"The neighbors won't mind," he said.
He raided my kitchen to the point I needed to go food shopping right away. And he wouldn't leave until I grabbed the phone and told him I was going to call the cops and then mom. After his visit, he kept telling people he was gonna live with me. I took longer to recover from the cold. And while cleaning up the mess he left, I found soot marks and even a needle full of strange stuff mixed in with my cat's toys. Mind you, I found that needle by the fact I almost got it in the foot. My home looked like a rock star trashed it. My friends came over and helped me finish cleaning. As the new year hit, my mom thanked me for helping my brother. And I told her, I am not. I love him for God's sake, I do love him, but he is not welcome to my home ever again. I am so mad at him, I don't want to see him.
But he's homeless.
His fault. He had over a year to find a place. I found one in less than 30 days when you guys kicked me out of the house.
But he is your brother.
Who partied like a rock star in my apartment and smoked around someone who can't even breathe. Yeah, not having it. Also, there was a needle here. You are diabetic. Is it yours?
No, I'll ask your brother.
That was the end of that, but a few days after that, my friend and I were at my place when my brother stopped in to check on me, as I was now mostly recovered. He explained the needle with an answer that was slang for a certain drug he said he was injecting into warts to get rid of them, and he demanded it back. I told him I threw it out. He offered to take out my trash, which I repeatedly told him I was fine. He finished by giving me a long-winded speech about how useful it would be to have him live with me. I literally had to push him out the door and tell him I would rather be eaten alive by piranhas than ever live with him again, as he is a nightmare. As it stands, it has been about 9 months since then. He is now mooching off his friend and still telling anyone whom will listen how he turned me down when I asked him to live with me. My mom is honestly getting a bit of a laugh out of it since my brother has been changing the story so much over all this time. I haven't seen him since I made him leave, and honestly, I am good with that. Sounds like an amazing attendee of your family reunion, right? Just the kind of person you'd want to have a semi-forced association with. Like, that's just ridiculous. This story's called Homophobic Karen Thinks My Friend Is My Girlfriend. We give her something to stare at. Oh. This happened late last year, in the good old days before Brovid. I was out having coffee with my best friend, who we'll call Jessica. I'm a 29-year-old female, and me and Jessica have known each other for most of our lives. We went through primary school together, and she's been there for me through thick and thin. Because of our long friendship, we're really close. Her 4-year-old son thinks we're sisters. We went to our favorite cafe in town, and not long after we arrived, two women sat at a table on the other end of the cafe and almost immediately began to glare at us. I should mention that my hearing is more sensitive than most people, so I can hear what most people can't. When the two women began talking about us, I could hear everything they were saying. They were far enough away that they thought we couldn't hear them. Jessica noticed them staring at us, but couldn't hear what they were saying. But she knew that I could. I'm not gonna repeat what the Karens were saying because they weren't nice things and don't deserve a reenactment. They thought that Jessica and I were a gay couple, which they had a problem with. I'm bisexual, which Jessica knows about, but she's 100% straight. Our friendship is purely platonic. But instead of ignoring them, which would have been the more mature thing to do, we decided to give them something to stare at. I told Jessica what they were saying and shared my plan with her, and she got the biggest grin on her face and agreed. So I, while looking at the women, pulled Jessica towards me and gave her a passionate kiss on the neck, then another on her cheek, and then followed it with a smooch on the lips. I glanced over at the women and gave them a big smile and a wink as we continued to drink our coffees. After a shocked look on their faces and them muttering disgust to each other, they both got up and left. As they walked away, I gave them a smile and a one-finger salute. This is probably the most mild entitled people encounter I've had, but I thought I'd share it. Jessica and I still laugh about it to this day. Well, hello! Interesting story, with interesting events. my question is, so those two women, they saw two other women sitting down at the coffee, and their assumption was that they were a lesbian couple. But they were literally doing the exact same thing as them, so either they were doing something that seemed kind of romantic and, you know, suggestive, which obviously it doesn't matter, it's none of their business, or one of them, or both, are projecting because they could be gay. Wouldn't that be a plot twist for the books? Alright, here's a story called Encounter with a Xenophobic Karen. Shouldn't everyone be xenophobic? Because I don't know about you, but xenomorphs are something you don't want to trifle with, okay? Unless you're the Predator. In which case, then yeah, trifle with the xenomorphs. Okay, that was a joke. Don't be a xenophobe. That's not nice. Anyway, for this Brovid thing, everyone has to use a mask. So the only visible part left are the eyes. I have slanted eyes, but I'm not Asian. I'm a Native American. Lately in my country, the government informed that they are discussing a law which would allow victims of human trafficking to access a special visa. I was in the queue in the supermarket waiting to pay for my groceries when a 50-ish-year-old lady started to talk how those filthy immigrants were responsible for an increase in poverty and crime rates. What a booty hole, I thought. Then she looked at me, to my eyes, and said, "Look at her! These Chinese were the ones who brought the virus! Immigrants are making this country a rat hole!"
Excuse me?
And you, where are you from?
From here?
But your parents aren't, are they? I mean, look at you!
I was dressed comfy. My parents are from here too.
See, you let them in, they have children, and then they think they own our country.
I ignore her and proceed to pay. I used my debit card, but it got rejected. My bank was hacked, and I forgot I had moved my money to another bank. So I asked the cashier if I could pay with actual money.
Look, she's a deadbeat!
Or una muerta de hambre. Okay, lady. First of all, I'm not Asian. I'm a Native American, and this is my country. My ancestors lived here before this country even had a name. And you can save your comments for yourself. Because you are very likely to come from an immigrant. She was blonde and had bluish eyes. You racist old hag. I packed my things and leave the place. I have Native American features. Brownish skin, slanted eyes, notorious cheekbones, and kind of big nose. And lately, my country has been dealing with serious things about natives. They're accusing us of terrorism. Some people have called me a flippin' Indian in my social nets. And the Brovid thing was also stressing. People saw a pair of slanted eyes and they treated you like you had the plague. That's not good. No matter your freaking opinions on immigration or whatever, that's no excuse to treat someone like that. You can't just assume you have more of a right to live here than just any random person you see walking down the street just because they're not white or something. Because, as she, OP, said, Native Americans been here longer, buddy.
They've been here longer.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to never miss an episode.